Hey, Northland, would you stand as we engage our hearts today? Can we do this? Can we close our eyes? Can we take an opportunity to zone in and focus on how intense, how real, how dark that Good Friday was 2,000 years ago? Come on, he's given us powerful imaginations. We're going to use them to engage our hearts right now. Come on, with your eyes closed, would you imagine the Last Supper where Jesus told his disciples what's about to happen and fears in the room and pain is in the room and rejection with his close friend and disciple Judas, rejection and betrayal, and going after that to the garden where they're praying and Jesus feels alone and abandoned. Maybe some of you can relate with that emotion. Oh God, would there just be emotion that fills our hearts? God, let us actually become in tune with this reality as we sing and as we pray. And Jesus finds his disciples sleeping, and then the guards and Judas show up, and Judas betrays Jesus with a kiss, and Jesus is taken away and brought before rulers and beat up and spit upon and mocked. Come on, this is the Jesus that we worship every week, the one who is perfect and mighty to save and incredible, the one who we sing his praise forever. He was brutally beaten and whipped and scourged by mere humans who thought they knew what they were doing, thought that what they were doing was best, and man, were they wrong. And Jesus is up there, and he's got up on the top of the mountain after a brutal journey up the hill, up the mountain, carrying his cross, and they put nails in his hands. I mean, I just squirm thinking about it. But can we embrace some of these realities today? And then they put the cross on the ground, and he's hanging by these few pieces of metal. I picture one in each hand and maybe one on his feet. Ugh, it's gruesome. That he was barely recognizable as himself. His mother Mary at his feet, crying, weeping, guards shoving people around. Just a gruesome scene. And how in this moment, Jesus meets people with compassion. He's still thinking of others, and he cries out to God, "Why have you forsaken me?" Because he's actually quoting David in the Psalms, as he feels so overwhelmed to the point of death. Oh God, we get our perspective and our eyes right now on you on the cross. Come on, I'm just going to wait a minute before I sing. Would you just be engaged in your own way? That what he did, what he was doing was intentional. And we know the end of the story, but there's something powerful about sitting in the depth of the emotion, the intensity, to remind ourselves. Just like when we watch a movie like The Passion of the Christ, it reminds us what really happened, it reminds us how real and intense it was. Can this service be that for us right now, you guys? I know we've gathered together and we're excited to see each other and the weather outside and all this different stuff, but what if we just locked our eyes on Jesus on the cross? Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, before the world began, above all kingdoms. above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known. Above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified, laid behind the stone, you live to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all. Oh, I'm so thankful for what you did, Jesus. I'm so thankful. Picturing you laying on that cross, you didn't have to do it, but you did it anyways. You could have stayed in comfortable glory, but you did it anyways for us, God. Oh, he did it for us, church. Man, these verses are hitting me in a deeper way than they've ever hit me, because the verses of this song, because we're talking about how powerful and how incredible and how he's the thing above all else in this world, even back then and today. And yet he is the one that was crucified. Come on, can we sing that again? Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. As we sing this verse, can we think about how much he's forgiven us of? Of all kingdoms, of all thrones, of all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified, laid behind the stone, you live to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above. Like a rose, oh, like a rose trampled on. Come on, have that imagery in your head. Oh, like a rose trampled on the ground, you took the fall and thought of us above all. Above all, above all. Worthy is the Lamb, seated on the throne, crown you now. high and lifted up. Jesus, Son of God, darling of heaven, crucified, worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb. Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the price you bearing all my sin and shame. In love you came and gave amazing grace. Thank you for this love, Lord. Thank you for the nail pierced hands. Wash me in your cleansing flow. Now all I know is your forgiveness and embrace. Is your forgiveness and embrace. Come on, Northland. Worthy is the crown you now with many crowns. You reign victorious, high and lifted up. Jesus, Son of God, the darling of heaven, worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb.